Bring on tonight, baby.
Hello!
Take four total strangers. Each hosting their dream dinner party.
I don't drink wine, but I will have a glass of champagne.
I think she's definitely going to be trouble.
Spice things up with some secret scoring. The result, hearts fluttering.
Cheers, you look lovely.
I definitely like Lilly a lot more tonight.
He's like a little puppy. I just wanted to put him on a shelf. Stay.
Head's growing.
As the daddy.
On all levels, he's passed every boundary.
And he goes spiralling.
You have cash and you flash, and you know that you're flash.
Come on.
As they battle it out to win a £1,000 prize.
Hey. Raj, leave my Lilly alone.
This week we're in North London, birthplace of Sir Joseph Bazalgette, designer of the capital's sewers. And hoping his food doesn't end up down the pan is our first host, flashy 40-something Raj Bahad.
I've created a whole fantasy in my house. My house is banging.
Welcome to the Raj Mahal. Complete with disco lights, electric hand dryers and dedicated poker den. Classy.
The Raj Mahal is going to create the biggest wow factor.
I really can't stand people who are into their materialistic sorts of life.
Bet you'd like a big house, though. Introducing contestant number two, no-nonsense HR advisor, Annette Ankrah.
I have been told that my mouth is a weapon of mass destruction. I say what I think. Whether you agree with me or not, I don't really care.
Charming attitude. In the kitchen, Raj is still admiring his assets.
My, bum doesn't look too big in this, does it?
Your bum's not in it. He gets on with his main, the worryingly named Love You Long Time Cock and Bull.
Cock and bull meaning, chicken, the cock, and beef, the bull.
That's a relief.
This person seems like they might not be all there.
You might be right. He's marinating his beef in custard powder.
The custard powder just helps with the marinade a little bit, so I've been told.
Raj will stir-fry the beef and chicken just before serving.
I probably wouldn't give my dishes names, just because, I mean, you don't really see that at Michelin-star restaurants.
Michelin. Meet Rusty Warren, a man with rather lofty ambitions.
Yeah, I'm just in chat here. I was wondering if you wanted to pop for a coffee at all. Yeah, I like to pretend to be posh.
My ideal girl would be definitely more raw than council. I do love a raw girl. Absolutely love him.
A lot of people would say that I'm posh.
Including me. Definitely a raw girl. This week's final competitor is nutritionist Lilly Abrahmsohn.
You should be looking for the crunch of the coffee bean. People say I am the most well-spoken person that they know.
La-di-da! Well, let's see what you make of this. Raj's starter, Machi Dubacha.
It's either a mash de bash or it's a Machi Dubacha.
No, it's actually pronounced
Machi Dubacha, which means son of a fish.
Same to you.
I don't think they'll know what it is unless they're Asian, because it's an Asian phrase.
I did French, but...
Not going to help you here, fella.
Maybe something about cheese?
Nope, not even close. Machi de Bacha is actually seasoned tilapia fish, which Raj will fry tonight.
Bish, bash, bosh. Done.
He'll be serving the fish with aloo tikki, which are seasoned Indian potato cakes. Last up, dessert. An homage to his house. Sweet treat at the Raj Mahal.
The last time I checked, it was the Taj Mahal.
Not this one.
And that's going to be a Bailey's cheesecake.
Not especially Indian. For the topping, Raj mixes together cream cheese and Irish cream liqueur.
It's the menu of a man. Little bit wacky. A little bit out there.
I made a mistake! Please work!
He adds sugar, then stirs it all into whipped cream. Oh, get on with it! Finally, he puts the mixture on top of biscuit bases and leaves them to set. After a quick change into some velvet,
let's get ready to rock and roll!
is ready to receive wannabe toff Rusty.
Hello, how are you?
I'm not too bad, I'm Rusty.
Welcome to the Raj Mahal. I'm Raj.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. Come in, Rusty. I'm hoping there'll be some ladies here tonight.
Fingers crossed.
Yeah, man.
There better be.
I hope so.
That's one way to make your male guest feel welcome. But he's in luck. Next in, fine filly Lily. Brace yourself, Rusty. She's a real-life posh person.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. My name's Lily.
Nice to meet Lily. I'm Raj.
Hi.
Welcome to the Taj Mahal. Or Raj Mahal.
Not quite as funny when you get it wrong.
Hi, how are you?
I'm
Rusty.
Rusty.
Lily.
Yes.
When Lily first came through the door, I was like, ding, ding.
No chance.
But I'm playing it cool. I'm playing it cool.
Yeah, really cool.
Let me warm you up.
Oh, right. Oh, okay.
Get off her!
Raj, he's very eccentric.
That's one word for it.
The whole hugging thing. I think some people might find it a bit too affectionate.
Someone whose mouth's a weapon of mass destruction, perhaps. Here's Annette.
Hello.
I say hello!
Oh, my God!
Can I get you a glass of bubbly?
I don't drink wine, but I will have a glass of champagne, if you've got champagne.
Champagne,
No.
I don't have any champagne at the moment.
That is
I have
fine.
Prosecco.
I don't drink wine, I don't drink Prosecco. I do have my own little bit of rum in my bag.
It's the lady's got class.
Is it one of those metal...
It's a really...
Champagne.
Oh.
Blimey, she doesn't mess about.
I think she's definitely going to be trouble. She sounds very opinionated. I get that vibe straight away.
Annette is sort of like a queen bee. She comes in with her head held high, more like swans in, and then trails with her this air of authority.
So is she a bee or a swan or what? Never mind. Coming up, Annette attacks.
You're just like that. You're lying.
Annette is quite opinionated.
Raj ramps it up.
Slapped it up.
They have fake snake skin on doors.
Raj's flash.
And Rusty romances.
I love you.
He was looking into her eyes like he wanted to just kiss her.
Tonight we're in North London, where flash boy Raj Bahad is out to impress three strangers with an extravagant dinner in a battle to win £1,000.
I got a feeling tonight is gonna be a good night.
I've got a feeling you should do some cooking. To finish off his starter, Raj fries seasoned fish and potato cakes. Meanwhile, his guests have a rummage round the Raj Mahal.
Is that like... I wonder how deep
is
that
is. Is this snake skin? Is the door snake skin?
It'd have to be a fat snake.
I mean, they have fake snake skin on doors. How more materialistic can you get?
Yes, not old money like you.
I can imagine walking in and being greeted by someone who wants to give me some aftershave. Not in somebody's house when you're going to a dinner party.
What do you think he does?
Potentially an interior designer.
Would you let him design your house?
His toilet just says OTT. He's obviously trying to portray and to us that he has money.
Wow.
For him to have this casino thing in his house, he's obviously playing with real money. I would be playing with
you wouldn't have a
coins,
table just for the hell of it.
I feel like Raj would be someone who would wear a big silver chain with a pound sign at the bottom of it.
This poker table thing, it's all the money and it's all money orientated, and that's a men's club thing that can be left out of the house.
From a pimped up pad to a pimped up plate, Raj's starter is served. Machi Dubacha.
Where's its origins from, in terms of the recipe?
Machi the Bacha actually means son of a fish, so I just thought of the name.
Oh, you made it up?
I made it up.
Mm. What fish is it?
This is tilapia fish.
Or tilapia, even.
Tilapia.
Ah, okay. Tilapia, yeah.
Yeah, tilapia fish.
I was just like, oh, God, I'm doing tilapia fish. Mine's obviously going to be better, because it's me. But his was good, and I can't actually say it wasn't. His was good.
I thought... it was a bit out there, Fish, for a starter.
Yeah, really crazy. Anyway, surprised you even noticed the food.
My tactic with Lily this week would probably be to play it a little bit cool. I'm going to keep the ladies' man persona.
What ladies' man persona?
I'm going to try and up the rah a little bit, just to float her boat a little bit more.
OK, yeah. Your host's taking a less subtle approach. Good luck, ladies.
Give him some love, girl.
Thank you. That is fantastic. Thank you very much.
He's a little bit too touchy-feely.
I could imagine that a lot of people would be embarrassed by that and could feel like their privacy was invaded.
I want some more love, girl.
What?
Once he's finished groping his guests, Raj moves on to his main.
Slapped it up. But
yo, it's so street, man. He starts by frying some veg.
Supposed to heat the chicken up first.
He starts again by stir-frying some chicken.
It's taking far too long. I don't want to even take half out. It's taking too long.
I feel like he's doing a bit of his gym workout in there.
Yeah, I feel like I'm not hungry anymore because my belly is eating out itself.
It's a lot of work. That's why I'm stressed, because it's a lot of work, it's a lot of prep.
It's only a stir-fry, get a grip.
If you couldn't do it in the time, you should have done another meal, to be honest with you.
Finally, there it is, the aptly named Love You Long Time Cock and Bull.
Right, are we ready? Yeah. Are we ready?
They've been ready for the last 45 minutes.
There you go, madame.
Oh, this looks fabulous. The Millennium Dome.
That's one way to use a chopstick, I suppose.
Mmm, lovely.
It was nice, but it sort of reminded me of my local Chinese takeaway. So just, it was like an egg fried rice with a beef dish, with a chicken dish.
Yeah, he was probably aiming higher than that.
I don't think Michelle Roux would serve it in his restaurant.
Stop pretending you've been.
The plate was Raj to a T. It was definitely style over substance.
Back at the table, Lily's showing off her own style.
This is the way I like to taste, but you can follow suit.
She's really posh. I don't think she knows how posh she is until I start speaking. How can you say, this smells fruity like a winter's morning? That's to me, just, you're just like
that.
You're lying.
Annette is quite opinionated. I sometimes think that's quite refreshing. But then there are times when, you know, you've got your heart broken by a boy and she's like, look, he never liked you.
What are you on about?
You're but ugly. Then that's the times when you don't want honesty. And I feel like she'd give it then as well.
So have you always had this house? Because your house is quite quirky. There's a lot of character in it. So is that a reflection of you?
Definitely. I want to come home to a lifestyle. And I've created my sort of lifestyle here. It's not about being flash. It's about being just... I'm very house
proud. Come on, Raj. This house is all about flash.
Raj is flash. Raj shouldn't even act like he's not flash. You're rich and you like showing that you're rich, which is fine, but just act like it.
He's doing a pretty good job of making his pudding look flashy. Here it is, sweet treat at the Raj Mahal. Bailey's cheesecake to the rest of us.
Rusty, a little bit intrigued about your name.
My real name isn't Rusty.
Okay.
My actual name is Rusticus.
That's much better.
My middle name is Christopher Sydney.
Sydney? Olivia Hope Sydney?
No Sydney way.
Get
Sydney.
Out.
Is that with a Y or an I?
Why?
Why?
No way.
That's it.
Way? Taxi, anyone?
Yeah, me and Lily have got the same name. What is going on? A bit random, but another niche to the bow.
String to the bow.
I think the flavours of the dessert worked quite well together.
If I was going to score myself, it'd have to be 30, 40, 50, 100.
There's a surprise. Back in the real world.
Tonight, I'm going to give Raj an 8.
Tonight, I'm going to give Raj a 7.
With the delay with the main course and the blandness of the sweet chilli chicken, tonight, for that reason, I'm going to give Raj a 7.
So Raj kicks off the week with an above-average score of 22. Show off. It's day 2, and young Rusticus is out to impress a certain someone with his hosting skills. The look of
Lily closely matches what my kind of ideal girl is. So yeah, hopefully tonight I can pull out all the woos to woo her.
Rusty likes her, but I don't think Lily actually sees that.
That's because she's more concerned with figuring out what's behind your hard exterior.
Annette is a really strong character. She doesn't give much. There's not much facial expression, there's not much emotion, but I feel like she's someone that you could tease that out of over time.
Good luck with that. Back in his kitchen, Rusty's getting on with his dessert. Raspberry and lemon posset.
Sounds nice. Nothing fantastic.
Don't go overboard. Rusty starts by mixing cream, creme fraiche, lemon curd and honey.
Hopefully it's not just the dessert tonight that woos Lily. Hopefully everything does.
Lemon and dessert for me isn't ideal.
Bad luck, Rusty. To finish, he pours the mixture over fresh raspberries and adds melted chocolate. Next, it's on to his main, loin of venison with red currant jus.
Is that like a pigeon?
No.
I'm not into pigeon at all.
Just as well it's deer, then, not pigeon. For the jus, Rusty fries garlic and shallots with truffle oil, red currants, juniper berries and port.
I'm definitely trying to impress my guests tonight with my sophisticated menu.
It's not really working so far. Let's see what they think of your starter. Wild mushroom tartlets.
Nothing complicated there. I don't really like mushrooms.
It's such an easy thing to do, wild mushrooms. You just basically go and pick some mushrooms from a tree.
Hey?
And make it look like a tart.
I think it's a bit more involved than that. Rusty fries his mushrooms with garlic and parsley, then rolls out homemade puff pastry and uses it to parcel up the filling. You better get your glad rags on.
I'm suited and booted, so bring on tonight, baby.
Let's hope you know who likes it. And here she is now, Lily.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
How are you?
I'm good. Come on in.
This is for you.
Wow, thank you.
When Rusty opened the door, and he was all in his little tie and waistcoat and smart trousers and smart shoes. My heart melted a bit.
Good sign.
You know those costumes that you can get for your little puppy?
Not such a good sign.
It's like a little puppy suit. I just wanted to put them on a shelf. Stay.
Terrible sign.
Cheers, you look lovely. Yeah, Lily looks good tonight. I'm loving the sequin shorts.
Yeah, she thinks you look like a puppy. Next at the door, it's Tough Cookie and Annette.
Hello. How are you? Look at you.
Hello.
Your tie, you need a bit of showing how to do that.
Really, can I not do my tie properly?
Don't mince your words. And finally, Mr. Flashy Pants himself, Raj.
Hello. How are you?
My man. My favourite Julie's.
Booyakasha.
You call it Julie's.
Lovely.
Put her down.
Oh, fine, thanks. Fine.
Cheers.
Thanks, Rusty.
Cheers.
Well, let's crack on then. Here's the starter now. For gluten-free Lily, mushrooms with rocket salad. And for everyone else, wild mushroom tartlet.
Dig in, guys. I hope you enjoy it.
I can't believe you actually made a puff pastry. No one really. One makes puff pastry.
Nice. The mushroom didn't do anything for me. The pastry is dry.
It was too crusty for me, Rusty.
Oh, a poet!
The leaves weren't dressed with anything. They were naked, and then they had the mushrooms just hovering on top.
Okie doke, so I'm going to go prepare your main course now. It shouldn't take too long, but I need to know how you like your meat.
What is venison?
Venison is deer.
Yeah.
Bambi.
I thought it was a pigeon. I really thought venison was a pigeon. Vermin, venison.
The fact that Annette thought it was pigeon doesn't surprise me. And she's so honest about it. She's like, I thought it was pigeon. What, so sue me?
She's sort of grown up, it seems like, with a silver spoon in her mouth, where I've sort of had the copper one.
I definitely like Lily a lot more tonight than I did last night. So this one's going to be Lily's.
No favouritism, Rusty. Here it is, loin of venison with a red currant jus, which is a first for Annette.
Do they actually kill deers to eat, or is it like
when they get run over?
No, they're killed.
Roadkill.
Yeah, because why would you kill a deer?
Back where I originally come from, it's classed as a sport.
Trying to impress someone, are we?
And on Boxing Day, there's quite a big... it's called a meet, and it's where they all go off with the dogs.
So, basically, like, a gang murder.
She's real. She keeps it real. And I love that about Annette.
This venison seems to be a posh person's beef.
Mine's perfectly cooked inside.
Yeah?
Exactly how I wanted it.
You're on a roll, Rusty. What else have you got to offer, Lily?
Well, I aspire to be an actor.
Ooh. Oh, no way.
Yeah.
Like theatre?
I studied acting, and that's my qualifications.
How many different types of laughs can you do?
No one asked Laurence Olivier that.
Oh, was that it?
I've got my high-pitched laugh.
That must come in handy at auditions.
What do they say when you sort of do that?
I don't normally go in and be like, you want me because I can do this.
That sort of says crazy to me.
It was a bit uneasy, and I think he should stick to his day job.
Rusty's acting skills were rubbish.
He wouldn't be hired by me.
Oh, dear. It's all resting on dessert. Rusty's serving raspberry and lemon posset.
So you've got the raspberries that are a bed on the bottom. I just
There's
added
raspberries
the mix.
On the bottom. How am I meant to get...
You've got to dip down deep, girl.
Nice.
Well, Rusty, we know you can act.
Do we?
Can you sing?
Oh, no, please don't!
And I see
oh, no, he is!
True colours shining through.
Stop him!
And I see your true colours, and that's why I love you.
He was looking into her eyes like he wanted to just kiss her, and I was like, whoa, what's going on here? A
beautiful... Where are those taxis?
He's got a good voice, and it's great that he can act and sing and host.
She's impressed.
So hopefully I can work on that a little bit throughout the next few nights and try and woo her a little bit more.
I just really thought dessert was awful.
And it was just huge and like almost like a brick.
So tonight I'm going to give Rusty a 6.
Tonight I'm going to give Rusty a 6.
I felt so great all night because he really hosted well. So for that reason, I'm going to give Rusty 7.
Super! But it's still not enough to take him to the top. Rusty finishes his night with 19 points. Coming up, confrontations.
Do you fancy Lily?
It's always an awkward topic. Love.
Confessions.
You were definitely flashy.
Who else is going to elaborate on that one?
And catastrophes.
Oh, God, look what's happened.
He's just trying to get more laughs and be the centre of attention.
It's day 3, and straight-talking Annette Ankrah is trying to host her way to £1,000. But posh Lily is still trying to work her out.
Tonight, my goal is... to crack her with a nutcracker and see what's inside.
Sounds painful. And anyway, Annette's more interested in matchmaking.
There's a bit of flirting going on with Rusty and Lily, so maybe tonight I'll get them to do a little bit of dancing together and see if that seems to blossom a little bit more.
Dancing? The singing was bad enough.
Well, now that my night's over, I think I can relax a bit more now. So it means that I can kind of spend a bit more time focusing on Lily, getting to know her a bit more.
Back home, Annette is preparing her starter, tilapia and yam fish cakes.
I think it'll be more difficult for Annette now because she's tasted my tilapia fish and I'm sure she was really impressed with it.
A tilapia off.
Ding, ding, round one. Annette starts by cooking her fish fillets in milk and boiling chopped yams.
Yam fish cake. Is yam a fish?
Wake up, Rusty! Tilapia's the fish, you only had it 2 nights ago. She mashes the fish and yams together with a spicy paste and pats into shape, ready to fry later. For her main course, Annette's serving suya lamb kebabs with jollof rice.
I can only expect nothing less from a Ghanaian princess like Annette.
For the jollof, the Ghanaian princess blends together onion, red pepper, chilli and tinned tomatoes. She then uses it to cook the rice in.
I'm not sure what suya means.
It's an African kebab using ground nut and spices. She'll grill them tonight.
I do feel that my baking skills are excellent.
If you do say so yourself. Now's your chance to prove it further with dessert. Sable biscuits with exotic fruits and mango coulis.
It's very floral. She's not a floral person.
It says fruit. Fruit, not flowers.
I sort of feel like she's going to appear with some flowers in her hair.
Annette needs to get a butter, flour and egg to make the biscuit dough. Once rolled, she cuts into shapes ready to bake.
I can't see her making a disaster out of it. I'd like to see her make a disaster out of it.
I bet you would. After a quick change and some final checks, Annette's ready for first guest Lily, who's on a mission to crack her host.
Hello,
Lily.
Pretty.
How are you? We're going to start off easy, but then it's going to get really hard, so I hope you're into it.
Crikey, what have you got planned?
Excellent. Okay. The big
stuff. Next in, it's the King of Bling, Raj.
Oh! Sexy!
Yeah! And finally, lover boy Rusty.
Hello!
Watch out, though, someone's eyeing up your girl.
No, you stop that.
Yes, please stop.
I feel like he just wants to touch everything. I seem to be his target.
Quick, get in there, Rusty, save her!
How are you, darling?
Rusty!
Your knight in shining armour.
How are you?
I'm good, yeah. Good.
Woo! Annette finishes off her starter using the same fish Raj used on his knight.
I've got a feeling that he's going to try and play his one down as being a little bit better, but I don't think it is anyway, so...
There's only one way to find out. Here it is, tilapia and yam fish cake.
So I thought I'd give you a bit of taste of West Africa tonight.
This is absolutely delicious, brilliant.
Thank you.
Success! He genuinely likes it.
Annette's starter was, for me personally, a little bit of a letdown.
Oh, no, he doesn't.
OK, guys, so you know I like cocktails. If I was a cocktail, what would I be?
So you know how sometimes you have, like, a woo-woo or a blue lagoon?
Yeah.
You would be, on the menu, your Ghana love this.
Woo! Quite clever for you.
Oh, my God. And you had so little time to think about that.
Oh, she liked that, Rusticus.
And a half. You are punny.
I am punny.
OK.
It would be a straight vodka shot. Because it's direct.
Yeah.
You know, get the hit directly. And it'd probably be called AnnetteDirect.com.
I love it. Thank you. Raj didn't actually finish my starter, which I think was a bit rude, considering I finished all of his.
Maybe your main will be more to his liking. Suya lamb kebabs and seasoned jollof rice.
This is jollof rice. I don't know, have any of you ever tasted jollof rice before?
Yes.
Never.
You have a friend.
And the kebabs also have got African seasoning to it, so let me know what you think.
I didn't like the meat. It was very strong. Very pungent. I think she over-seasoned it.
The lamb. It was raw. It was raw. It was raw. It was raw.
I think it was raw.
It was raw.
One thing I had to make sure was that the lamb was not well done, which I...
Mission accomplished.
Do, so I made sure that it was sort of medium rare for them, and I think it went down a blast.
Afraid not. Back at the table, Annette's doing what she does best, getting straight to the point.
Listen, AnnetteDirect.com.
Yes, thank you.
Do you fancy Lily?
Lily.
No comment.
Ah, that's a yes.
That's
that
a
is
yes.
A definite yes. BeDirect.com. Rusty.
Go on.
Yeah, Lily is a beautiful girl. She's got a great personality and she would be my ideal.
Yeah!
What? It's always an awkward topic. Love, isn't it? Especially when it's off the cuff. So, I didn't really know what to say.
I am currently dating.
Oh. Oh, straight through the heart!
It was a bit of a smack in the teeth to find out that Lily had a boyfriend.
if I'm a taken woman, what can I, how do I respond?
Get rid of him.
Right now.
Like right today.
Now. Say, like, in your face.
Like right. Today.
This is my man.
But, oh, Rusty's so sweet. I do hope he finds the perfect woman for him. I'll try and get myself cloned.
My week's work has gone to waste.
Don't give up that easily, Rusty. You can still show her what you've got during Annette's entertainment. Maybe not.
Annette's been great as a host. I really like her. It just shows that if someone's got a poker face permanently, that they actually aren't thinking bad things and they're really nice. She's great.
Uh-oh, Raj is off again.
Raj is very hands-on with Lily and Annette. It's very touchy-feely. I'm not sure whether they're enjoying it. Maybe they're just too nice to say.
You're obviously not. Time for dessert. Sable biscuits with exotic fruits and mango coulis.
Guys, now we're on the third day. Do you think that sort of impressions have changed of each other?
I've got to hear this.
You've got to hear this. Can I stop talking and hear?
Okay.
You are definitely flashy.
Okay.
You're really extroverted. You're really eccentric. And it, honestly, it comes across all the time, actually.
Okay. Who else is going to elaborate on that one?
You have cash and you flash, and you know that you're flash.
Oh, come on!
Don't even try it, yeah. Raj. Don't try it.
I don't think I'm flashy. I might come across as flashy, but yeah, fair comment. I take it.
Don't think you like that. Taxi!
I don't think Raj liked my honesty. He seemed to respect it, but I don't think he liked it.
Annette's dessert was sort of like a building, with the two bricks and then the cement in the middle. But it did taste nice, not like bricks and cement.
Well, that's a relief.
Annette was absolutely brilliant, fantastic, great host, but the food wasn't to my expectations. Therefore, I'm going to give her a respectable 7.
Tonight, I'm going to score Annette a 7.
The entertainment was amazing, and I finally cracked Annette. I'm going to give her a 7.
Okay, then! That's 3 7s, putting Annette into second place so far with 21 points. Day 4, and Raj is dwelling on last night's home truth.
Rusty called me flash last night. I don't think I'm flash. I think Rusty's probably a little bit intimidated by me.
I think he might be living a lie a little bit, saying that he's not flashy, playing it all down, trying to be humble.
I'm Raj, I am who I am.
Whether they like it or not. And in the kitchen, final host Lily's feeling the love.
This machine is the love of my life. It does everything. The only thing it doesn't do is scrub my floors and make my bed. But, and tell me it loves me. But, I mean, sometimes it does.
I love you, Lily.
I haven't really been overly impressed by the food so far. So I think Lily will really, really have to pull something out, something spectacular out, because at the end of the day, this is a competition about food.
Oh, get a room! Or get on with your dessert! Surprisingly fun cupcakes!
Dance group might pop out of one of the cupcakes or something, knowing Lily.
There'll be fairies, there'll be loads of things happening with these cupcakes. I'm really excited.
Do tell, darling!
They're going to decorate their own cupcakes, and they can take it home in little boxes.
Oh, is that it? At least she's having fun.
Oh, perfect!
Lily mixes butter, sugar and flour.
Let's whisk that up. Woo! Gets quite excited. It's getting quite puffy. Puff Daddy in the house!
She adds vanilla extract, baking powder and milk, then lets the machine do all the work.
Can you just look at that? It's heavenly. It just looks like I could just eat that raw. I could have a raw cupcake. It doesn't even need to be cooked. I mean, I wouldn't be disappointed with that.
Think your guests might. Finally, she pipes the mixture into cupcake cases and bakes. Then moves straight on to her appetizer. Butternut squash soup.
I'm actually not a big fan of soup.
Bad luck, Rusticus!
I never, ever have soup. It's like a savoury drink.
Well, if you serve it in a cup, that's exactly what it is. Oh, hello.
I'm going to serve the butternut squash soup in this little espresso cup.
To make the soup, she's using that machine again. In go the ingredients, she presses go and gets very excited.
Oh, my God, it's literally going to take off. I swear, it's going to go to Mars. This is probably what they're going to do to invent a way to get into space. Ooh. And then they can have nice soup when they get there.
I think they can already get to space. The soup will be followed by her starter. Spring rolls with dipping sauce. And for this one, Lily actually does a bit of work herself.
The soup starter is a bonus, and the spring rolls are just the main starter.
She wraps stir-fried veg in rice paper, ready to deep fry tonight.
It's not what I was expecting at all. I was expecting caviar or something.
Well, you're going to be disappointed with her main course then. Thai green curry.
I thought it'd be quite a richer menu, and this one just seems pretty boggy standard.
I think you mean bog standard. Anyway, Lily doesn't agree.
Thai curry is an art. I went to Thailand, did a Thai cooking course, so it should be good.
For her homemade own curry paste, she mixes garlic, shallots, ginger and spices. There's that ruddy machine again.
I love it.
She sweats onion and adds the paste, then the chicken.
This should definitely win me the prize.
She pours in coconut milk, fish sauce and palm sugar.
Pablo Picasso will be proud of me.
I don't remember him having a tie period. Finally, she puts in mixed veg.
They don't love this. It will be a crime. A crime.
Stop admiring your work and go and get changed. Your first guest is approaching. It's Rusty. Remember him? You broke his heart.
How are you?
I'm good, yeah.
Lily's from a Lily.
You've got to give him some credit for trying.
Oh, you look lovely.
Thank you. I love this jacket.
Shame about the massive pollen stain on your arm.
Cheers.
Cheers.
To the last and
I
best.
Know.
Just kidding.
Next in, it's Annette.
How are you, sweetie?
I'm good. How are you, direct.com?
Direct.com? I'm in the building.
She's running with that nickname. Last in, it's Mr. I'm not flashy, but I did have to bring the biggest bunch of flowers, Raj.
They got the diamantes in there. This is my bouquet.
Size isn't everything, Rusty.
Look how stunning these diamantes are.
I's the daddy.
It was a bit uncomfortable when Raj entered with his big, massive bouquet and me with my little humble one. I just wanted to give the more personal approach to it. I even wrapped it myself. I don't know whether anyone noticed.
Well done.
And I even got the pollen covered on me.
We noticed that.
Listen, this is the last night. We want to party like it's the last night. Okay.
Cheers, guys.
Coming up. Raj gets revenge.
He had his night. Now it's Lily's night. Take a back seat.
Relationships are ruined.
On all levels, he's passed every boundary.
And the result is revealed.
Second place.
Tonight, final host Lilly Abrahmsohn is doing her utmost to cook her way to the £1,000 prize. She's feeding her guests before they've even sat down.
I like to serve soup as one arrives.
Oh, does one?
One more coming down.
Not sure this lot are quite so refined.
A spoon would have been great for the starter, the soup, definitely.
I actually really don't like soup. It was tasty. I just hate the consistency of soup, especially in a mug or a cup. Sorry, Lily.
You've blown it now, Rusticus. Time for the next course, spring rolls and dipping sauce.
Yeah, nice. I can see a lot of attention to detail here. The flowers, candles, even the pink and the leaves. Right? It's fabulous. You're a dark horse. It was only a teeny, beany, one spring roll. I mean, I expected minimum 3 spring rolls.
Greedy!
I was let down.
It wasn't enough for me at all. Sorry, Lily.
You're only making it worse!
So, I have some special wines tonight. One of them you just tried, it was the red sparkling wine.
Oh my God, look what's happened!
Oh my God.
I do definitely think that Raj set her menu on fire, so the attention was on him. He tried to make it out like it was an accident. I know it wasn't an accident at all.
Smoking, baby!
Smoking!
Caused a house fire.
Yeah, you did, but you didn't.
I don't really know what's been going on with Raj this evening. He's been a bit over the top, I think.
I'm feeling a little bit worldly, wicked and wise tonight.
I feel like my food's going to be delicious, but it might be just served up with a little bit of anxiety.
Let's get it out quick then. Lily's main is Thai green curry.
Tastes very fresh. Very fresh.
There's definitely a lot of flavours in there. A lot of flavours.
I was disappointed with the Thai curry. I think it was the bamboo shoot or the ginger that was a little bit overpowering for me.
You know, a Thai green curry is all about spice, OK? And getting it right, it's fantastic.
Thank you.
It's absolutely delicious.
Oh, you little fibber!
It was just a bit of a letdown for me.
Sorry, Lily!
Sorry, Lily.
Guys, it may seem like a silly question, but I think it's fun, always. If we were to describe each other as animals, which animals would we choose?
To me, he's a little bit of a... an ostrich.
You will never believe this!
That's it! You're an ostrich!
You'll never believe it, but I, on safari...
Yeah, safari, yeah.
...weeks ago, I saw ostriches mate.
Come again?
Yes. Come on, do the ostrich.
Okay.
You are fucked.
Oh, don't humiliate yourself anymore, Rusty, please.
Well, I'm very glad that I got to mate with Lily tonight.
In your dreams.
Even if it was as an ostrich.
This is what happened with two birds mating.
Yeah, and safari.
Wow, that's a lot of information.
Too much. Speaking of which, Raj wants to be centre stage again.
Annette, you've got a really amazing pout. I've noticed that tonight. That's what models strive for, and you've got it, like, all day long. Look at the cheekbones, the pout, elegance.
Just find it a bit uncomfortable. I don't know if he's doing it for just being nice sake or if he's just a little bit of a perv. Can I say perv?
You just did.
I need a volunteer now to give me a kiss. I don't mind who it is.
Don't you dare.
I know exactly who I want to kiss.
Step away from the women.
You can look, but you can't touch. Please don't pick me.
Watch this, OK? Watch this. No. I'm just being Raj tonight, and the ladies have been absolutely gorgeous tonight.
Raj, leave my Lily alone.
Feeling left out, Rusty?
That was boring. I tell you what I'm going to do right now. Honestly, and it's got to be like this.
Not anymore.
Oh, my God! Stop!
That's the most I'm getting all evening.
I'm afraid so, fella.
It really is. It really is.
I mean, if Raj had done that to me, really, I'd have to go to the hygienist, sterilise my mouth, probably rip out my teeth and tongue.
Bit extreme. Well, let's hope your DIY dessert keeps him occupied.
You have to decorate your own cupcakes. Oh my gosh.
Raj, you're really going over the top with this, aren't you?
I mean, it's Raj to a T.
Raj has actually been so over the top tonight. He's just trying to get more laughs and be the centre of attention.
He had his night. Well done. Now it's Lily's night. Take a back seat.
Oh, my God.
Sweet.
Oh, my God! You're my hero. Oh, my God. What is that?
That'll be the antique Venetian table decoration.
I mean, on all levels, he's passed
every boundary. He broke my anti-table decoration. He almost splattered the whole cupcake tower on the floor.
At least someone's still having fun.
It wasn't a dessert, if you get what I mean, but the fact of, you know, getting to have a go yourself, it was such a different twist. And I've still got sticky fingers.
Well, you better wash them then. It's time to score.
Lily put on a great night, fun, entertainment, attention to detail. The food really lacked for me, therefore I'm going to give her a 7.
Tonight, I'm going to give Lily a 7.
Lily needs 9 to take the grand, and there's only one person who might give her that.
Tonight, I'm going to give the most beautiful Lily...
Hold it there, Romeo! With all the scoring done in secret, it's down to Lily to reveal the winner.
Hey!
I said that, I was like, I can't deal with it.
What? Spit it out!
4th place. Rusty. Second place. Annette and Lily. Raj won. I mean, put me in a jar, shake me around and call me Fred. I am angry!
Settle down, Fred.
Ooh. Well done, man. Fantastic.
The other 3 should have won, and he should really give us 250 each. That's what I think.
Quick, now's your chance to grab it.
Isaac, Daddy, you get me now. Woo!
What was that about not being Flash?
I'm so happy. I'm ecstatic for him. So happy.
But I see your true colors shine through. I see your true colors. And that's why I love you.